once again, we are the Edcouch-Elsa Mariachi Cubanina sticker. I don't know if you caught that in the opening song, but that's our theme song. It's a custom-made song that we write every year for the kids to go out and introduce themselves. So they say, Cubanini, Cubanini, and at the end, a sticker, that's our name. So we go into the song that we went into called La Gallera. How many of us are fluent Spanish speakers? Couple, all right, awesome. So I'll translate for you. Basically, that song is talking about being a gallera, okay? So in the galleros and galleras, back in the days of charros and, all right, yeah. So they go out and basically they're talking about a little bit of woman power in that song, right? So it was recorded by an all-female group. And so you see a lot of woman power nowadays in mariachi. Now I'll talk a little bit about the history and all that, but let's get to some more music because they want to play for you. So they always tell me, talk too much, sir, and we'll get to play that song. This next song is called Yo Creo Que Es Tiempo. It's a ranchera polka, or a ranchera corrida, and I'll talk a little bit about where they come from, but we're influenced by a lot of different genres in different countries and different parts of the world. So the polka comes from Germany, and so this is a ranchera polka that is 2-4, makes you want to dance, but it's going to feature one of our soloists, Jocelyn, singing Yo Creo Que Es Tiempo. And then from there, they take only the best in the state to formulate like an all-star mariachi, but they call it an all-state mariachi. So this year we had one make it from all-state and we had one from last year. So our all-stater, you just heard her sing, she's from last year and she made all-state by her day. This year, it's even more tough because every year they keep adding people. So we had four All-Staters last year, three graduated, she stayed behind with us. And then we had one make it this year. And he still has a chance to make it again next year, hopefully, because he's a junior only. But he's one of the best. He came out second chair trumpet in the entire state of Texas, Josiah Martinez. It's a tough field to go into, but we're very fortunate that we came out with all stages to get the best treatment and for that year to go out and go to the TMA Infinity concert. But these kids work so well together. It's crazy, but every year is a new puzzle for me to put together. So all these guys are basically playing together for maybe their 6-7 months together as a team, because we graduated 12 seniors last year. So this is a rebuilding team, as we like to say, but you caught them at the right time of the year where they're nice and fine, they went to contests, they went to region stuff, so they're peaking right now. Unfortunately, by the end of the year, those three seniors you saw are gonna go on, and now we have another puzzle for next year. But we keep most of the puzzle pieces together starting the year. So just a little history there of how we do things here in our region. But let's move on, let's go with, so this next song is a cumbia. So cumbias are influenced from what region or what country you think? Colombia, they actually come from Colombia. Okay, so we took some of that little flavor that they use over there and put it in mariachi. And so of course they're real popular for our culture and our genre of mariachi, plays and cumbias. This also was a style that was adapted by Texas into Tejano music or Norteño music, and so all those Spanish cultures use cumbias. They're perfect to dance to. You want to get up and dance, pick your favorite dancer and dance. Here we go. Como la flor featuring a couple of our vocals.
Thank you.
this next style of song comes from Mexico, and it's originated from Mexico. In Mexico, there's all different types of regions and areas where music is so different within the country itself. And so mariachi music was was founded in Jalisco, Mexico, or somewhere right around there, in a place called Copuna. And so these traditional song styles are mariachi, called Sones Jaliscienses. So they got the title from Jalisco, Mexico. And that's the original style of music that we played in mariachi back in the day. And so mariachi's been around for over 100 years, going on 200 years of documented mariachis playing in Mexico. It started with the word came from when the French came over, but they used to use that from the word mirage, and then they combined it with mariachi, which is the wood that they used to dance on for the dancers. And so mariachi turned into mariachi as ensembles started popping up and playing all over Mexico. So that's a little short little history of the word itself, the origin. But mariachi quickly became popular all over Mexico, and now it's evolved to being full-blown in even the schools in the United States, and it is really taking off in Texas and taking off all over the U.S. right now. We get calls from Iowa and from, you know, Chicago and from Florida and from Arizona. People want to start what we have in Texas over there. So all you guys that are from different states, tell them we got some good stuff over here that you want to take back to your states and maybe different countries. But it's going up. It's really taking off. And so mariachi education is in the right spot at the right time right now for the kids to be a part of. So this original song style comes from Jalisco, Mexico. It's the original birthplace of mariachi music. It's called El Son de las Guacamayas, and it's a traditional son jalisciense from Jalisco, Mexico. Next song, I'm going to take you outside the box of mariachi. So we believe that mariachi can do anything with the instrumentation that we have. We can kind of adapt different styles. And so I'm not going to tell you the name of this song. I want you to hear it and be able to recognize it for yourself. But it's a little bit out of the box of what we do typically in mariachi. You're going to hear these songs played down in Jalisco, Mexico, probably over in Colombia. These are Americanized songs that we kind of adapted for mariachi. So. It is in English, so it's something that hopefully you can understand a little bit better for those that are non-Spanish speakers. But it's something that we've done year after year. We try to give them something different to do, so that the audience can recognize it and appreciate. So please enjoy this rendition of an American classic. The dress, the attire that they wear. So Mariachis typically were wearing just some white abedas and some like white colored suits and just real simple back in the day, but it became adapted that they took on the traje de charro. And so charros were known as the Mexican cowboys. And so they were, of course, well-dressed and they were playing for dignitaries and they were doing that sort of thing. So now it's not uncommon in schools to see students fully dressed in the traje de charro. So these are the best of the best suits that we can get them. Thank you for doing that here. Wow. So I'm gonna have Sophia come up to the front so we can demonstrate the suit. She'll be our little model. So there's a three-piece suit. If you turn to the side, it's another suit of gala. These suits are all decked out. So the gala is the metal adornment along the side. Sometimes you'll see the suit with just the metal part. Sometimes you'll see a suit with just the embroidery part. These suits have both. Okay, so they have the embroidery, multiple colors, they have the adornment on the side, on the front they have the necktie, the one one. It looks like it's a fancy necktie, but it's just a little. And then in terms of the back, they even have the fancy bows that we get them. They get the fancy earrings. They've got the bell custom made. They've got the boots that go typically with the braque de charro. The hat is customized to match the suit. So I mean, they're decked out. With these kids, for each suit, you're talking about easily $1,000 for the complete suit. For these type of suits, you can go simply. You can go with about a $500 suit or $600 suit. Take it to the plain black, the dress, and the drawing on the side. No accessories covered. Okay, so these guys are a little spoiled because we've worked up to that, but they've also earned it. They've had several years of playing and playing and going out and competing, and so every year they give us a budget to work with, and we go out and we do our thing to build up to what they have now. So,
Mr. Garcia, can you tell them what grade they start?
Yeah, so they start with sixth grade. I mentioned earlier that we have a program of about 150 students district-wide. And so they start with us when they're babies, sixth grade. And so we get to kind of mold them, give them the background, the fundamentals and all that stuff for sixth grade. And then they move to seventh and eighth grade with us. It's the same team of directors. That's the beautiful thing about Edcouch-Elsa. We're a small district. We have one high school, one junior high, and one sixth grade campus. So we get to follow them all three in the same day. So if I can't get them to sound like that in 7 years, that's really on me. Yeah, so if the seniors that you hear are playing, they've been playing for 7 years with us. And most of them do complete the program. Once they get to this level, the varsity level, then they're competing continuously throughout the year and doing that sort of thing. Like I said, we do have multiple levels. You saw how many freshmen we have, how many sophomores we have. So we still consider a younger group because we have a lot of sophomores and we do have a good class of juniors and very little seniors, so that's good for us that we get most of these kids coming back and then rebuild those three pieces of the puzzle that we're missing. We'll be missing a guitarrón, we have a senior guitarrón player, we have two violinists that will be graduating for this year. So it's not bad. Continuing last year, we lost 12, and 10 were in this group, so you take 10 out of any group, that's a big chunk. But these guys have worked hard to gel and to get together. Unfortunately, it's the last part of the year that they get to play together, and then we got to start all over with a slightly different group. But they went out as a group, did well. We would go to this big contest called UIL. UIL is a big thing. They covered sports, they covered academics, they covered fine arts, and now they have a full-blown mariachi contest every year. So it's been the ninth year in a row. Edcouch-Elsa has gone 9 times in a row. We've gotten straight 1 superior ratings 9 years in a row. Out of those 9 years, I think 6 years, they get these distinction medals. Like, if they like, I like that violin player, I'm gonna give him one because he stuck out as an outstanding performer. Well, 6 out of those 9 years, we took outstanding performer medals for the entire ensemble. They give everybody a medal. And then 3 of those years, we still got a medal for at least 1. So we're the last school standing in Texas that every single year we've gotten at least 1 medal. And got the straight one superior ratings all the way through. So I don't like to just say it, but I like to prove it. But we are one of the best programs in Texas right now, currently.
Mr. Garcia.
So we'll talk more about the dress and all that after the next couple of songs. This next song was one of the ones that they took to UIL. They go out and play 3 songs, they only get 10 minutes to show off their stuff. There was 90 groups this year at UIL. That showed up across the state of Texas from Lubbock all the way down here in southern tip of Texas. Out of those 90 groups, there was only 4 that brought back the distinction of straight ones and all performance medals. Edcouch is one of those, and the other 3 were right here in the Rio Grande Valley as well. So it's thriving down here in the valley. Of course, we're close to the border, we got that culture connection, but we have some very good instruction and very good talent to work with. So this song is called Luz de Luna. It's a show song that Mr. Cidal, one of the directors, couldn't be here today because we have other classes going on as we speak, so we had to cover those as well. But he's one of our rangers for the district, and so him and I take the majority of the work. So everything we hear is customized for the kids. We don't just go buy songs off the shelf. We have to custom arrange them for the kids. So this is his idea. He had an idea of writing the song out in a more modern style, more fancy harmonies, fancy patterns, and it was definitely something that turned the heads of the judges, and they were super appreciative of the nice arrangement that we put on this old school mariachi song. So please enjoy Luz de Luna. guys enjoying the show so far?
Yeah.
These kids work so hard, so I always like to thank them in public. They hear from me every day. I'm on their back, right? But I think at the end of the day, when they can come out and play for you guys and sound this good, it's a good thing that they can get in front of people and go out and showcase their talents, because they need to be showcased all over the world, in my opinion. So we're working on different things, but we have been fortunate. This is the reigning, well, not reigning, but we've already accomplished 2 national titles as a group, and we've accomplished 3 state titles where we go out and beat everybody in the 5A. And the national contest happened in San Antonio, but it is groups that come down from Vegas. They're booming with Mariachis right now in Las Vegas, Nevada, and California sometimes brings groups, Arizona. So we've won a national title 2 times at different locations, once in San Antonio, once back before these guys were even in school. In 2007, we won a national title in Orlando, Florida. So we have 2 national titles, and we have 3 state titles. Those 3 state titles came back to back to back up until 2020 was the last one. So 2020, 2019, 2018, back to back to back state titles. So this year, we'll be going to go compete at that particular contest in April, coming up in about 1 month from now. So if you guys happen to be around the San Antonio area, it'll happen at Somerset High School. You can follow all our events coming up at our website, eemariachi.com. And so we're going for hopefully a run for another state title, but even if they don't go and bring back the top prize, just to come out top 3 in our division alone, it's super difficult. And so these guys have never dropped out of the top 3 in the state title race. They've always coming back first, second, or third, first, second, or third. Sometimes we give it to our buddies over in Roma and Rio Grande City and Calvin and those guys, but they're pretty strong as well. And so they're all friends and colleagues of ours, and so it typically stays in the valley. I mean, 5A has never left the valley with that state title, but it is coming up, and so we invite you to follow along. If any of you can't make it in person, they have a stream that you can watch the kids, and it's a pretty neat deal. So follow us on eemariachi.com. This next song is an oldie but goodie, and we kind of converted it to Spanish, so we found it again. We like finding those little diamonds in the rough. There's so much available out there to choose from for music nowadays, with the internet being accessible. And so we found this old people way that we converted to Spanish. And so it's called Amor de Estudiante. Please enjoy.
Thank you.
I want to talk about the instrumentation, Mariachi, for a quick second, or a quick minute, should I say, right? So, Mariachi has instruments that we use in other genres of music. You guys are very familiar with this instrument in front. What's that one called? It's called the violin. Some people say, that's a fiddle. Yeah, it is. We're playing the right kind of music, right? So, fiddle and violin are the same thing, but we have our violins here in front, and they're using classical music as well. We have our trumpets up there at the top. And so they're typical B-flat trumpets that we use in concert bands and in jazz bands and salsa bands. And then we have our classical guitars. Raise them up a little bit, guys, so you can see your guitars. Those are classical nylon string guitars, not steel string guitars. And so that's become the typical traditional instrument for the mariachi as far as the rhythm section. And then you have that one. Can you flip it over to the back of the end so they can see the backside? That one looks like a guitar, a little bit smaller. Right in between the guitar and the vihuela, but that's called a guitarra de golpe. Probably didn't even notice how that is a little guitar. It's a guitarra de golpe, it's a little bit little deeper sound. So can you play me a son jalisciense, Elizabeth, so you can hear the sound of the guitar? Good. Okay, now can we try it on the guitarra de golpe? A little bit boxier sound, you hear that? Now this one is a vihuela. If you show on the backside of that, it looks like a little turtle, right? It's got that turtle-shaped back, and so that one is going to give us a more packed, a brighter punch, and a more powerful sound. So can you play us a son jalisciense on the vihuela? Okay, so when we put the high and the mid and the low together, then we get that nice gotten sound. So we try to use all three in mariachi. At the state level, they do encourage to use the guitarra de golpe as well. So we have the more of the lower sounds, more of the mid sounds, and then of course the high bright sounds. And then of course this guy over here, the big one, he's our guitarron. So if you turn over the back so they can see that as well, it looks just like the vihuela, right? It's got that turtle shaped back. And that's to help the sound resonate and get a little bit more of a punch so that we can play the acoustic. These guys are spoiled, they each have their mics and stuff like that. But when we go and play an acoustic performance, typically, it's going to resonate a lot with just having the sound of the bass. Without having to carry around a plug to plug in the bass, or having to carry around a big old upright bass, or a double bunch of they call it. So this is the sound of the guitarron. Can you play a little bit of the guitarron?
Okay.
So it does kind of touch, yeah. Bass. So a lot of us like bass on our radio, and that's where it comes from right there. That's the heartbeat of the mariachi. Now, these two instruments, actually those three, but mainly these two, were created just for mariachi. So the guitarron, they don't want to be carrying around that big stand-up bass, so they invented in Mexico the guitarron so that they can go around and play while they're strolling around and do that a little bit more practically. The vihuela was also invented, so they can do that. They don't need a guitar. They have a small ensemble of five. Get a vihuela and a guitarron together. Throw in a couple of violins and a trumpet. You got a little mini mariachi. Okay? But yeah, these two are made exclusively for the mariachi. And then, of course, if you didn't know, actually back in the day, they used to have only four members of the mariachi. And it began with the harp. It was the harp, two violins, and the guitarra de golpe, right there, that one, those four together. And so it was a small little ensemble. It was something that was used to move around and be practical. And then it grew because of when radio was invented, they added the trumpet to the radio. It was a more commercial sound, and they added the trumpet. It's more of a brassy sound. It became standard. They have three trumpets in the mariachi. Sometimes they use up to four. Became standard, they have at least six violins, typically six to nine is standard for now of big groups. At least one guitar, typically they have two or three, and then at least one golpe, one vihuela, one guitarra. Okay, so harp, can you guess a little bit of the harp? Actually uses both hands, so it's kind of the equivalent of playing the piano. You're doing one thing with this hand and another thing with this hand, so you have to have some coordination there. We have a very young harpist. We had the reigning all-state harpist for the last 2 years, and so he graduated from us last year. But these guys have picked up and filled the shoes beautifully because I have a freshman and I have a sophomore. So the future looks bright for the Heart Players here at Edcouch-Elsa. And they're going back and forth to get that top spot, and they're both doing really well, so we're proud of them as well. So all together, of course, you have the violins, you have the armonía section, and you have the brass, or we call it the trumpet section. So it's difficult because people don't realize when you're teaching mariachi, it's like, oh yeah, let's start the mariachi at our school, it's nice and easy, but we're dealing with trumpets, which are typically from the band program. We're dealing with strings that are typically from an orchestra program. Then we're dealing with guitars, and that's the classical. And we're dealing with voices, that's a big thing, it's like a choir program. And then we have to deal with theatrics and all the drama these kids cause. Now I'm kidding. When it comes to the staging and the drama, literal drama, like, we try to teach the kids to be natural and use their hands and sing and be more theatrical, because nowadays it's evolved to that. It's not just going out there singing and looking scared. They have to be more enthused about it. So it's a lot of work that goes in. These guys manage it beautifully, amongst being in some of the top UIL programs, being early college students, being in sports. How many of you guys are in sports? Raise your hand if you do sports as well. So we got a lot of athletes here. How many of you guys do early college classes? So they're all taking early college classes at the same time. How many of you guys are on path to graduate with an associate's degree by the time you leave high school? Okay. So at the end of the day, we realize that they're giving us a lot of their time, and we're very appreciative of that, but at the same time, they have a lot to juggle. So high school is not like it was when I was there, and probably not like it was when you were there. So it's evolved us so much, and we're grateful that they're here and they're able to do what they do. So this next song is a special song that we like to bring to these kind of occasions. It's a song that we hope you'll enjoy, something that's, again, an English tune that we arranged this year specifically for these kind of deals, where we can show off not only the violins playing violin, but the violins being able to play a little bit of fiddle music. Okay, so this is a song by Johnny Cash, and it's something that we adapted for mariachi so that you can enjoy not only the violins featured on fiddling, but we have some amazing vocalists as well. I mentioned earlier Josiah Martinez, he's our trumpet player up there, and so he was all state, not just because he's a great trumpet player, which he is, but he's also a great vocalist, and you'll see that right now. So I'm going to use Josiah along with Adiel, along with Daniel, to sing a little trio with some nice country music for you guys. Please enjoy our Johnny Cash rendition.
Thank you.
Awesome audience. It's always good to share our music with people from our hometown and of course a little bit further into our community. And then you guys, they get to take this music and these videos and these pictures and everything back to your hometown. So who's the one that is the furthest away? Out of state, I'm sure most of us are.
Kansas.
Canada? Wow, awesome.
Kansas.
Kansas.
Minnesota.
All right.
Iowa.
Richmond.
Virginia?
Pennsylvania.
Okay. We were over in Philadelphia a couple years back. Yeah, we did a show for NSBA. So this past summer, we were fortunate that we got the invite to go to Hollywood Bowl in California. So we were there in Hollywood. We've done Pennsylvania, or we did Philadelphia, I'm sorry. And we did another California trip previous, and then we also did Orlando, Florida. So we've been very fortunate. We did D.C. We played in the White House one year. We got to sing in front of the White House another year. But yeah, these kids have received invites, and so we're looking forward to being able to share that music further. This final song is their closing act. It's a song that we took from another region of Mexico. And so it's called Edcouch-Elsa. It's going to show off a little bit of the violin, a little bit of the vocals and the nice three-part harmonies that we put for that. And then afterwards, you guys come up and take pictures. You can ask questions and visit with the kids for a little bit before you have to say goodbye and head back and take the class. They have to go to class this week. So thank you again for being a great audience and look forward to seeing you soon. Don't forget EE Mariachi is our website, eemariachi.com. And you can go there and you can follow us and come over to our free concerts. We have these concerts twice a year over in Edcouch-Elsa, and we feature not only these guys, but from the babies all the way up to the pros, right? So there is a full-blown concert at our beautiful fine arts facility there, and we invite you guys to come over and keep up with us. Thank you.
Thank you.
Once again, Edcouch-Elsa, Mariachi, Kenwood, Azteca. Washington. Thank you so much. Thank you for having us.
Thank you for watching. Thank you for the kids. Share on social media now and share it back at home.
And so the kids are here for you guys. Thank you so much.